Thank you for coming this afternoon. We hope you enjoy our program. This is Salt Lake City Blues.
Thank you.
I'll go any further when I introduce the members of my committee and acting interim jazz studies director. We have, help me.
Joe?
No, no.
Oh, Don.
Don Schaefer. Excuse me, Don Schaefer's in the middle here somewhere.
Don.
Thank you.
This next song I collaborated with, and my lyricist is here today with his daughter. I'd like to have Dave Seiler and his daughter Aubrey stand. Dave wrote the lyrics to this next song. And if you would welcome to the stage, Melissa Pace Tanner, who is going to be singing With Love and You.
Thank you.
This is Katrina Smith. And this is a song that I wrote for her last semester. A nice little jazz waltz a la Jean Toots Thielemans.
Thank you.
rest on that one because he's going to be doing some playing on his touch one. And actually, Zach and I are not going to play, and Dave's going to be, Dave Murphy's going to be playing a little bit later in this piece. This was written in 1722. Singers, and then later switched on Bach. There's kind of two schools of thought, you know. You should only listen to original Bach. Well, whatever can get you there. And so I think, as a student, I wasn't really into Bach himself, but I was into the Swingle singers and various things, and then I eventually did get into Bach. So it kind of got me around, kind of full circle. This is a three-part contention. Originally, I wrote this as a two-part invention, and it actually followed the rules and conventions of an invention. Then I added a third part, a harmony part, which does not follow the conventions of a three-part invention. So I have to call it a three-part contention, and the reason Dave is going to be on brushes is he's going to try to hold this contention together before we end it. So what you're going to hear now is something similar. This is one of my favorite keys, C minor, that Bach did his second fugue. And, but you're going to hear this instead with a little swing to it.
Thank you.
actually spelled G-R-E-Y. I spell it G-R-A-Y for a very good reason. It's based on a book, Oscar Wilde, and a movie was made in 1945 called The Picture of Dorian Gray. And it was one of Angela Lansbury's first movies that she was in. And so I've combined these various words into 12 Shades of Dorian Gray. And in 1959, Miles Davis wrote this. Actually wrote that introduction for Bill Evans on piano and Paul Chambers on bass. You're going to hear that, but in this form. And I cover all 12 Dorian scales in this piece. So here we go with 12 Shades of Dorian.
Thank you.
these great musicians. Evan Bateman on trumpet. Actually got this jazz master's program going. Henry Wolking. Henry, would you stand? And this goes back. Three of our faculty members, wonderful men who have all passed on and are probably the first band up there. Bill Fowler, Alan Waite, and the dear Lowell Hepworth. I started the University of Utah in the fall of 68. I have an undergraduate degree in psychology from 1974, an undergraduate degree in music from 1976. And if all goes well, the University of Utah will be giving me the third degree. In baseball, three strikes and you're out. With my education, 3 degrees and I'm out.